This video is going to be about converting between logarithmic and exponential form. So let's take a look at some examples so you understand what I'm getting at. Let's say I start with this logarithmic equation, the log base 2 of 8 equals 3. Now, I can convert this into something that's going to look like the following. I can take that base 2 and make it the base for an exponent. And the exponent is going to be 3. Because remember, 3 is the exponent that I raise the base to in order to get that 8. So 2 to the third equals 8. I've got the same numbers on both sides of the page, a 2, a 3, and an 8. And the relationship is the same. It's just expressed in two different ways. What if I write the log base 5 of 25 equals 2? Well, that's going to be the same as saying that this base, 5, raised to the exponent, the second power, so 5 squared, equals 25. Once again, I've used the same numbers, 2, 5, and 25. I've arranged them differently, but the relationship is the same between the numbers. Now let's write a general equation for what's going on here. So in other words, I can write the log and then whatever base I want. And after that log, I'm going to put some number. I'm going to call the number a. In mathematical terminology, the number you put after the logarithm is called the argument for the log. So I'm going to use a for argument. And then I'm going to say that equals x, just to remind me, like x and exponent, that a logarithm gives me an exponent as its output. And I'm going to write the other form of that, the exponential form, the base raised to the exponent equals a, the argument for my logarithm. Okay? So let's just do a bunch of examples converting from one form to the other to try to fix this fairly well in your minds. Okay, so here's my general formulas for the logarithmic form and the exponential form. And let's try something with, let's say, base 10. So log base 10 of 100 equals 2. How do I know that? Well, because the base 10 raised to the second power, the exponent 2, equals the argument of my logarithm, equals 100. Okay? Now, an interesting thing, when you have base 10, most mathematicians will not bother to write the 10. In other words, so I'm going to cross that out. I'll get rid of that. In other words, just like when you were doing radicals, and you had a radical sign, maybe the square root of 49. If you're taking the square root with a radical sign, you wouldn't have to bother to write a 2 as the index. It's understood. Well, if you see a logarithm without a base, then it's understood that the base is 10. Okay? Let's do another one with base 10. So what if I have the log of 1? Equals, well, that equals 0. How do I know that? Well, because the base, the understood base, which is 10, raised to the 0 power, any number raised to the 0 power, is just 1. So here's an interesting fact to bear in mind. If you have an argument which is 1, it wouldn't matter what the base is. The base could be 7 or 5 or 19. Because any number raised to the 0 power, any number raised to the 0 power is 1. Okay? Let's try a fraction. Let's see, can we do this? The log of 1/10. So I'm assuming this is the log base 10. And I'm writing 1/10 in parentheses just so we know that I'm taking the logarithm of the whole thing. And that's going to equal negative 1. let's prove that that's true. So that means we're saying that 10 raised to the negative 1 power equals 1 over 10. Okay? Well, and 10 raised to the negative 1 power is like 1 over 10 to the positive 1. And of course, I don't have to write that positive 1. So the logarithm of 1 tenth equals negative 1 is the same as 10 to the negative 1 equals 1 tenth. Okay? Let's try going in the other direction now. Let's try going from exponential form to logarithmic form. So I'll start over my exponential side of the page. Let's say I have 3 to the 4th. I know that 3 raised to the 4th power is 81. So let's see how I write that. I've got the logarithm. The base is the base of my exponential equation, base 3, the log base 3, of the argument, what comes after log, is going to be what that whole exponential expression equaled. So the log base 3 of 81 equals 4, because 3 raised to the 4th power equals 81. Let's do, we kind of did this already, 27 to the 0 power equals 1. Okay? So that means that the logarithm base 27 of 1, remember, anytime you have a logarithm of 1, no matter what the base is, it's going to equal 0. Okay? Let's start out with a fraction. What if I have 1/3 to the negative 1 equals, what is 1/3 to the negative 1? So let's see, that's going to be like 1 over 3 to the negative 1, which is the same as 3. So that means my base is 1/3. So I've got this fraction as a base, and my argument is what that whole exponential equation equaled. So the log base 1/3 of 3 equals negative 1, because my exponent was negative 1. Okay? And let's go for one more. So what if I start out with the fraction 3/4 raised to the 2nd power, 3/4 squared. If I square 3/4, I get 9/16. So in logarithmic form, that's going to be the log. My base over here is 3/4. What 3/4 squared equals was 9/16, so 9/16 is going to be the argument of my logarithm. I'll put that in parentheses. And that equals 2, because 3/4 squared is 9/16. Okay? So that's basically the process. You want to do this enough, get enough practice, so it's not at all confusing, so it's automatic. And then everything should be fine. That's it for this video. Take care. I'll see you soon.